Headlines were about Roseanne Arnold and LaToya Jackson. And in today's Inside Story, LaToya tells Entertainment Tonight the two have bonded together in their grief.
Roseanne called me last week. I was in Holland. And she spoke to me. And she said, "I understand everything you're going through. I've been through the same thing."
Singer LaToya Jackson and TV star Roseanne Arnold both claim that as children they were abused, and they've both gone public. LaToya writes about abuse from her parents in her new autobiography, and Roseanne spoke out about sexual abuse by her father. She spoke first to an incest survivors group in Denver, then on Larry King Live.
I remember being molested at 6 months old. I always kept it in and denied it because of the pain it could cause my parents.
When an Entertainment Tonight Us Magazine national survey asked about Roseanne's allegations of sexual abuse by her father, 53% agreed that it was a courageous act which would help others, while 37% thought it was a publicity ploy. Incest survivor Sharon Holland has only thanks for Roseanne.
It helps to have role models. Somebody model for you that it's okay to reach out, it's okay to speak out, and I think they provide a certain courage to the rest of us.
But Roseanne's parents appeared on CBS this morning to deny Roseanne's allegations against them. Their attorney, Melvin Belli, spoke with Entertainment Tonight in their defense.
All we can do is to say that we're not guilty of that. We've taken a lie detector test, which is the best, most objective thing that I know of, that shows they're 100%, 1,000% clean.
In LaToya Jackson's case about writing that she was abused as a child, 33% of those surveyed thought she was courageous for telling the truth. Yet another 52% thought LaToya was guilty of exploiting a personal matter. An expert in the field of child abuse says that credibility often becomes a delicate problem.
The real key issue in child abuse is the secret and the sense that nobody will believe you and the sense there's nobody to tell and that you will be blamed.
LaToya's parents have issued a statement contending there is no truth or validity to her accusations. But when LaToya was asked for a reaction to the poll results, she showed outrage that some might doubt her motives.
You think I enjoy going around speaking about this? It's a terrible thing to talk about, but you got to get it out of your system. You think I enjoy when my father used to make me do things with his penis? No, I didn't enjoy those things. I hated doing those things, but he made me do them, and he was my father, and I had no choice.
VET Us Poll is a random sampling of people who keep up with the news in the world of entertainment, as future stories warrant. ET and Us Magazine.
Jackson is the middle Jackson child, and her singing is well known, but she's branching out into the other areas as well. LaToya is also a businesswoman and represents the Mahogany Image cosmetic line. She's even on their board of directors. Welcome.
Oh, good to be here.
Are you in town as an entertainer or as a businesswoman?
Oh, no, strictly business.
And tell us why.
Well, we're having a convention here, the Bronner Brothers Convention, which is held annually every year, and I believe this is the 50th year. It's all new for me. Because I'm endorsing this cosmetics line, so this is my first, and I'm really enjoying it.
How long have you been with them?
I've been with them ever since April.
So what all does that entail?
That entails going to a lot of meetings, going to a lot of different stores, signing autographs, endorsing the products, seminars, and just looking at different faceovers and explaining how it's done.
Why did you decide to go with them?
That particular makeup line?
Uh-huh.
I've tried several others. I was offered to endorse other lines of product, but I liked Mahogany Image. I wore it for a while, and I liked what it did. It was something that I needed, that I was searching for, actually, so I decided to use it.
You have really branched out further in singing than probably most members of your family. You've taken acting lessons.
Yeah, a few.
And where do you want to go with that?
Eventually, I'd like to do feature films.
Ah. And you're singing. A friend mentioned that why is it the Jackson sisters started their careers a lot later than the Jackson brothers? Why is that?
I guess at one point in our lives, we didn't have an interest.
Oh.
Speaking for myself, I didn't want to do this. I knew that this was something that was absolutely out.
Oh, no kidding.
Yes.
When did you change your mind?
Well, I did. My father changed it for me.
That strong father of yours.
Yes, he changed it for me. He says, this is what you're going to do. They need a new act, and you're going to be a part of it.
Thank goodness you can sing, right?
And you don't say no to him. So I said, okay, I'm out there. And I started tap dancing and singing.
And you have a new record?
No, I don't have a new record. I'm currently working in the studio on new material.
Oh, on new material.
Yes.
And when will some of that be out?
That should be released the new year, actually.
Great. Is there sibling rivalry? Do you ever get sick of the attention Michael gets as compared to the rest of the children?
No, not at all. I guess our parents raised us quite differently. They always raised us to love and care for each other. And we're very happy when one succeeds, when one's doing extremely well. So there is no rivalry.
And he's happy for your success?
Oh, yeah. He's giving us pointers on what
to do. We haven't seen much of him since the victory tour. What's he doing?
Well, right now, he's just having fun in Florida, Miami. But he just completed a movie Disney.
Oh, that's right.
So he's always busy. He's always in the studio.
As are you.
Yes.
And we appreciate the time you took to come by here
today. Oh, thank you.
And good luck with the rest of the career.
Oh, thank you very much.
Right?
Really doesn't matter to me, and I really don't care if people were to say she shouldn't have done this, it was a wrong move, because it's my life and I have to live it for myself, and it was something that I wanted to do at the time.
Pendant la revue du Moulin
22 heures,
entre frères et sœurs, deux ans d'écart et des rapports de haine amoureuse. Vous pensez peut-être que Michael est excentrique à cause de son comportement, à cause des choses qu'il fait. Par exemple, les cerveaux qu'il garde dans sa chambre et tous les autres trucs de ce genre qu'il collectionne. Les gens trouvent ça très inhabituel et pourtant je comprends pourquoi il fait tout ça. Pourquoi il collectionne les cerveaux et tout le reste.
30 secondes.
Mais Michael, lui, n'a pas forcément compris pourquoi la Toya s'obstinait à publier son livre Jackson Story. Et il a tout tenté pour interdire le livre en vain. Car la Toya raconte de tout. L'exploitation des enfants dressés comme des animaux par des parents tyranniques. Calomane et la complicité tacite d'une mère sans tendresse.
Mercredi 12 février 1992.
Lorsque j'ai eu ce problème avec ma mère et mon père, c'est-à-dire qu'il m'a violée, je suis allée voir ma mère et je l'ai suppliée de me parler, de m'expliquer pourquoi il abusait de moi sexuellement. Ce n'est pas bien. Ma mère m'a dit, tais-toi, n'en parle à personne, personne n'a besoin de savoir. Je suis très heureuse d'avoir écrit ce livre car ça m'a libérée.
10 secondes.
Libérée, mais sans doute marquée à jamais, de même que Michael, devenu star mondiale du showbiz, la Toya n'a pas quitté le métier auquel elle a peut-être sacrifié son âme.
20 secondes.
Je crois que j'étais une petite fille et que ma famille a tué cet être humain. Mais maintenant, je sens que je m'ouvre comme une petite fleur et que je prends tout à nouveau. C'est une nouvelle vie pour moi.
22 heures, 44 minutes, 40 secondes. Mercredi 12 février 1992. Au quatrième top, il sera...
La Toya Jackson, celle par qui le scandale arrive. Son frère Michael fait danser toute la planète. La Toya, elle, sort à la fois un disque, textbox et un livre à scandale. Le mythe de la famille Jackson, la plus heureuse et la plus riche de tout le show business, 200 millions de disques vendus dans le monde entier...
On a toujours appris à faire semblant devant les caméras, les projecteurs... Faire semblant que tout est merveilleux, qu'on est tous très heureux. Mais ça n'était pas vrai.
Dans les années 70, les enfants surdoués Jackson pulvérisaient les hit-parades. Leur manager, Papa Jackson en personne, venu il y a quelques mois à Toulouse signer un contrat avec une entreprise de confection, le répétait encore.
Nous sommes une famille, nous sommes très unis.
Aujourd'hui, les enfants ont grandi. Michael s'occupe lui-même et plutôt bien de ses affaires. Janet marche brillamment sur les traces de son frère. La Toya, elle, déballe tout.
Mon père nous battait beaucoup. Il nous menaçait avec un pistolet. Il appuyait sur la détente. Il prenait des allumettes et nous brûlait les pieds. Et il riait quand il jouait avec le pistolet. Il riait quand il nous brûlait la plante des pieds. Il riait et on ne pouvait rien faire contre ça.
He would laugh, but you couldn't do anything about it.
La Toya se défend de vouloir exploiter la gloire de sa famille. Elle entend juste dénoncer les thèmes des mauvais traitements infligés aux enfants dans le monde entier. Le livre, en attendant, se vend bien, très bien.
Come on. Латоя Джексон в свои 39 хороша собой, бела лицом и очень похожа на брата Майкла. Правда, есть подозрение, что это семейное сходство достигнуто с помощью целого ряда пластических операций, хотя Латоя утверждает, что была всего одна, но удачная. Впрочем, бог с ней с пластической операцией, не только этим хороша Латоя. Однако, если по-честному, то в России мало кто знает что-нибудь еще о достоинствах сестры короля поп-музыки. Известно только то, что Латоя убежденная вегетарианка, да еще то, что славу она заработала себе благодаря скандальным фотографиям в «Плейбое». Деятельность ее как певица почти неведома российскому слушателю, хотя в России она уже во второй раз и в Москве уже выступала. Было это в 89 году в Олимпийском. Что же касается нынешнего визита Латои, то он был куда менее шумным и куда более скромным. В программе только один концерт в небольшом клубе «Утопия» перед, соответственно, небольшой аудиторией. Впрочем, Латоя утверждает, что число зрителей не имеет для нее значения, лишь бы слушали. И еще одно дополнение, имеющее значение в пятницу 13-го. Латоя на сцену выходит в этот день без опаски. В приметы она не верит.
Doing or what I was going to do, and I still don't know. No, I basically have an idea. I know that I'm introducing the girls, and that's what they told me I would be doing, basically just introducing the girls and a little bit more if I want, and intermingling with them if I choose to.
What does Michael think of women, based upon what you've heard and experienced?
He's actually had no interest whatsoever.
Is your brother gay?
You know, you are so just, you are so blunt. And very, you're just
I'm
right
just
to the
good,
point.
Latoya.
You
I'm
get,
just
you
good.
Get right to the point. You're just good, is that what it is?
You know, Latoya, for
you,
many,
you,
many
you
years.
You are the only one. You know, lots of people interview me, and you're the only one. You just get right to the point.
I cut right to the chase. You know something, Latoya? I'm one of, if not few, of the talk show hosts who has been a journalist for many years, and I believe in that old thing, so the people shall know. So that's where I'm coming from. But is he gay?